factor trinomials with GCF. Always factor the GCF first. If you are having problems factoring a trinomial, it probably means that there was a greatest common factor that you could pull out. Let's take a look at our two examples here. In our first example, we have 18, 21, and 15. All of those are divisible by 3. So that means 3 is a common factor. Then we have x in all our terms, and our lowest exponent is x squared, so that will be a common factor. So I'm going to pull out 3x squared by taking 18 divided by 3, which would give me 6, x to the fourth divided by x squared will give me x squared. Now I have 21 divided by 3, which would be 7, and x cubed divided by x squared would leave me x. And then 15 divided by 3 would be 5, and x squared divided by x squared would be 1. So I don't have any variable on my 5. I can now factor the trinomial part, the stuff in the parentheses, by using trial and error. So 6, first thing that comes to mind is 2 and 3x. I'm going to put those in. 5, and the thing that comes to mind for 5 is 5 and 1. There's only one way of factoring that. Now, it's really important to make sure I know whether I'm adding or subtracting my factors. Because my 5 is negative, I'm going to be subtracting my factors. So let's do our check here. I have 2x minus 15x, which will give me a negative 13x. Well, I have the sign right, but I need 7 and not 13. So let's try this again. I'm going to exchange my 5 and 1. And I'll put 1 here and 5 here. Now my outside is 10x minus 3x, which will give me 7x. I need a negative 7, so in order to do that, I need to change my signs here. Now that I've changed my signs, my negative is going to come over here in the last box. My positive will come over here in this box, and I've now factored it. So my final answer then for factoring this one is going to be 3x squared times 2x plus 1 times 3x minus 5. Let's take an example 2. Look at my numbers first. I got a 16, 28, and 30. Well, 16 and 28 are both divisible by 4, but 30 is only divisible by 2. So 2 is going to be my greatest common factor for that part. And it looks like I have x's in all of these. So it looks like I'm going to take the lowest exponent, which would be 1 for my x. And then when I divide that out, I have 16 divided by 2, which would be 8. X cubed divided by x would be x squared. 28 divided by 2 will be 14. X squared divided by x will give me x, and then just I'll have the y. 30 divided by 2 will be 15. X divided by x is 1, leaving me with y squared. Now that the greatest common factor is out, I can now factor my trinomial with trial and error. So the first thing that comes to mind for me for the 8 is 2 and 4. So I'm going to put 2 and 4x in there. And for 15, I'm going to do, let's put our y in, so before I forget that. I think I'm going to use 3 and 5 for 15. Again, this says that I am taking the difference between my factors. So let's check and see what I've got now. So outside I have 10xy minus 12xy, which will only give me 2xy. So that being the case, I need to change something here. So let's just move our 3 and our 5 around. Okay, so now we got outside, we've got 6xy minus 20xy. And that will give me 14xy. It's going to give me a negative, but I need a plus. So in order to change my, or to get my plus, I need to change my sign. So it's going to become a negative 6y, a positive 20. So my negative goes here. My positive goes here. So now, this trinomial fully factored is going to be 2x times 2x plus 5y times 4x minus 3y. And I'm done.